Hey guys, it's Roz, and back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing good on this sensational Sunday. I'm doing great. And if this is your first time coming to my channel, welcome, love and light to you, and many blessings. Please like and subscribe, hit the notification button, and drop a comment if you feel free. And if you're a returning sub, thank you for your support also. Love and light and many blessings to you. Today my video is about Twin Flame 101 Reflection after the Equinox. After September 22nd, we have been really dealing with a lot of stuff, and I was wondering about all the emotions I'm going through. Right now I'm listening to my Jamaican meditation music. It's like from the Jamaican resort. That is my favorite meditation music because it gets you going. I gotta pause for a minute because I gotta get my glass on. I'm sorry, y'all. I just hit pause and I hit it again and paused again. Drinking a sour green apple wine. I forgot what the name of it is, but it is very good. But yeah, I was listening to this Jamaican music, and today they have been, my friend Jen, she had sent me an email, a link, where between the 21st, I think it was the 21st or the 22nd, all the way to the 24th today, they're doing a mass meditation just to rise all the frequency throughout the world. It's just like people from Syria, Iraq, all different, China, Thailand. It's just so many different places. They're doing different meditations. And I was just like, oh my God, you know, been trying to get all my meditations. And, you know, basically through the equinox, it's just like looking throughout the things that you've been throughout the year. And basically, it's just like a midterm when you're going to college. It's just like all the things that they have taught you throughout school. It's just like life is just a big test. And it's just realizing, what have you learned throughout the year? I've learned so much about myself, about my gifts. Like as of yesterday, which was crazy. I don't know if you guys have ever watched that show with Zach Bagans. I think that's how he pronounced his last name. I'm sorry if he doesn't. And he has a show on the Travel Channel called Ghost Adventures. And yesterday, now mind you, I have not watched TV in a long time. Like, I just started catching up on certain shows that, you know, I DVR'd, and they were my favorite, but I was, like, very apprehensive on watching them. Like, can I watch this? Can I do it? You know, because last time I was always thinking mind control when you watch TV. You see certain things. You see certain symbols when people, you know, are throwing up different symbols. And it's just, like, really creepy because I hear, I'm sorry, it's just, like, through these long meditation songs, they have those ads to them, so it kind of gets frustrating. But yeah, I was watching, I was just in thought yesterday, and I guess I was just meditating, and it got really quiet, and I'm listening to nature and everything like that, because it was kind of raining on and off yesterday here. And all of a sudden, this lady, Debbie Constantino, comes up in my head, and she just starts waving, and I'm like, oh, hey, you know, that's the lady from Ghost Adventures. And then today I go on my Facebook and go through my memories of today's date. And I see today was her anniversary. And I was just like, wow, why would she pop up in my head like that? And all of a sudden, because I remember sending a post out for her 2 years ago when she had passed away, and God rest her soul. You know, she was murdered through domestic violence, and she was really an activist about domestic violence and stuff like that, and going through so many different things. It was just like realizing how strong my gift is. It's just like, because I was talking to one of the ladies I know on Facebook, and I started asking her, you know, my dad is telling me to say, you know, hey to somebody. Do you know these people? And she was like, wow, I haven't talked to these people in like six, you know, I've known these people for 16 years, this is a friend of mine. And, you know, and I, mind you, I don't even know this woman like that, to know people from her past, like from 16, 20 years ago, and I'm telling her, well, such and such said, hey. And then she was like, oh, wow, you know. And she was just like, but how does your dad know them? I was like, I don't know, they just told me to tell you, they said, hey, you know, I'll send them a message, don't shoot your messenger. So, it was just really, you know, really really crazy to actually know all that. And it's just a reflection on all the things that I've went through. And it's just like, sometimes I get sad, like I was telling y'all in my last video, that I went through things and I was sad about it. And I was just like, you know, things are gonna get better. And reflecting on it, you might not see it clear right now, but you know the way things keep popping up, because sometimes I'll get really dizzy, like I have vertigo, and it feels like I'm off balance, and then it's just like I'm stepping into a different dimension, like I'm seeing things just happening, like God only knows when it's happening, but I'm just like, wow, is this real? It's real, and I see myself in a different place, and it's just like, it's very foreign to me, but it seems familiar, like I've been there before. So it's just like, this is the time right now for you to reflect on everything that you have been through this year. The things that you went through that was bad, things you went through that was good. Because right now, I had to teach myself, even though I might be in a negative situation where I cannot change things. I can change myself, but I can't change the people around me. I can change who I deal with and who I don't deal with, but I can't change the people around me, but I can also change myself. It's like right now I'm in a predicament where I was kind of upset about something, and it was just like, you know, I had to step back because I didn't want to come out and say something mean or say something rude or something like that. So I had to just step back. Even though I was hurt about the situation, I was just like, just reflect on it. And it's just like, okay, did you learn something out of this? And it's just like, yeah. So, okay, you just deal with it when it comes up and just leave it alone. So it's just like, because before when I used to, you know, have a problem and didn't know how to react to it, I would lash out all the time and be trying to be mean and cold. And I try not to be that way, because especially if I feel like I'm at that point, I just don't say nothing at all. You know, I'd just rather for you to be ignored right at that time, and I really don't like ignoring people, but I'd rather for you to be ignored for that point or me coming out and saying something I might regret later. So it's just like right now I had to reflect on a lot of different things. It's just like I was washing my hair, you know, that's why, so y'all forgive me. It's like I'm really having some really curly cues going on today. But I just sat there and just thought and just like, wow, you have really gone through a lot of stuff that you have to really reflect on. The things that you have bettered yourself in is being a person, a better version of yourself. And that's what you have to really try to be. You're reflecting on the things that you know you need to change, things that you need to pat yourself on the back for, and just like, because now it's like my views are coming up, people are starting to come out and comment on a lot of things that I post, and I really appreciate all the comments you guys send out, and I try my best to go ahead and answer all of them. Especially if they're negative, I will not respond to it. I don't respond to anything negative. I don't have time for it. Because right now I want to spend my energy on things that have stuff to do with positive issues, positive views, and everything like that. So it's just like all the things that I have gone through throughout the year has really helped me grow. And it's like, yeah, I'm still going through some stuff, you know, but I was going to go through things. Things are not going to be perfect, but we're going to go through things, and you reflect on the stuff that you go through, learn from them, and keep it moving. Like I said in my other videos, don't cope. Do not cope with them. And that is some things that we really have a bad habit of doing, is coping with them. And that's why I had to tell myself, you don't need to cope with nothing. Just deal with it and let it go. You can't change what, you know, people do. You can't change what people say. You can choose how you react to it, how you respond to it, or you just walk away. Because some things is not worth a fight for. You ain't got to prove that you're right. Just like you ain't got to prove that they're wrong. And there's just sometimes I had a bad habit of wanting to do that, and it didn't do nothing except hurt me in the process. So it's just like, don't spend your energy on doing that. So I'm not going to hold you guys up today. And I will talk to you guys later. And I hope you guys had a blessed weekend and you enjoyed yourself. And I will talk to you soon. Much love and light. Spread the love. Meditate today. This is the last day to raise your frequency with everybody else in the world. So if you have time, I'm going to do it again tonight at 11:11. That's when it just seems like that's the time when you're channeled with your spirit guides. Well, I'm always channeled with my spirit guides, but that seems like that's the strongest time. So please like and subscribe, hit the notification button, and drop a comment if you feel free. And I will talk to you later. Peace and be wild.